Feeling a bit chilly in your grow room? Plant growth rates slowing to a crawl? Winter temperature extremes outdoors bring a whole host of additional challenges to growers indoors, especially if you're growing in an attic or a poorly insulated room. Cold temperatures, especially around the roots, will shut down your plants and in severe cases, cause cell damage. And here's what you can do about it. First, the obvious stuff. Monitor your minimum and maximum temperatures over each 24-hour period with a min-max thermometer. Get into the habit of resetting it every day. For warm season crops, I like to see daytime highs in the mid-70s and nighttime temperatures no lower than 58 degrees Fahrenheit, ideally somewhere in the low 60s. Cool season crops do better at 50 degrees Fahrenheit during the night and 60 degrees during the day. Now, if your plants are in vegetative development or are not sensitive to photoperiods, the easiest way to combat a cold snap is to run your grow lights for 24 hours a day. Sure, this will increase your electricity bill a little, but then again, so will plugging in a heater. Again, I recommend adding more grow lights rather than plugging in a heater. Of course, if your plants need shorter days, say just 12 hours of light, you might have no option other than to plug in a thermostatically controlled heater on a timer. Just be sure to run your grow lights during the night, say from 7 p.m. to 7 a.m. This will combat outdoor temperatures when they are at their coldest, and many energy companies charge less for the nighttime electricity use too. Okay, on to the not-so-obvious stuff. Cold roots are the big no-no here. Now, plants grown in media-less systems such as NFT, DWC, or aeroponics are more susceptible to cold air temperatures because, well, the roots lack the insulation that growing media like rock wool, coco coir, or soil usually provides. The answer is simple. Warm up your nutrient solution. Yeah, use an aquarium heater to bring temperatures up to 69 or 70 degrees Fahrenheit. You may also find that increasing your nutrient strength by 20% helps your plants take up the nutrients they need with less water. Remember, plants transpire less in cooler conditions, so commercial growers compensate for this with increased nutrient concentration. If you're propagating cuttings or seedlings, use a heat mat attached to a thermostatic controller. Now, if your plants are in pots, try wrapping insulation material around them and make sure they are not sitting on a cold floor. Raise them up a little here on some polystyrene. It takes a few good days to warm up cold media too, so if you're potting up plants, don't use a potting mix that has been sitting in a cold shed for the last few months. Warm that stuff up before you plant up. Extraction fans should be linked to a day-night fan speed controller. These clever little gadgets automatically reduce fan speed when your lights are off, helping to raise up those minimum temperatures. Also, make sure you are taking your grow room's incoming air from another room in your house, preferably a warm one. Grow tents can be easier to heat than an entire room, so if you live in a continental climate zone, you know, that is cold winters, hot summers, then check out the Ideal Air Pro Series air conditioners that cool your garden in the summer and heat it in the winter, all very efficiently too. Okay, I hope some of that was helpful. Remember, there's no substitute for a well-insulated growing environment in the first place. Buy the highest quality insulation material you can afford and go overboard with it. And don't forget to invest in a proper day-night fan speed controller if you haven't done so already. Take care of yourselves and your plants. This is a very cozy, calm, warm, and content Everest. Out.